Welcome back to the Hank Strange Situation, Lifestyles of the Locked and Loaded.
Make sure to check out hankstrange.com. You can sign up for our email list and find ways to follow and support our efforts. Go ahead, Patrick.
I was going to try to change the subject. Can we bring it back to modern ATF?
Mm-hmm.
What do we need to do to get them straightened back out? Because I feel like from your experiences, you may know more about the insides and outs of how they run. And
yeah, or should it be abolished? Because there's people out there that would say abolish the ATF. Me, I say that all the time, by the way. Full disclosure. ATF
has been on the bottom rung of what is important in the federal government.
Mm-hmm.
So you have certain political interests pushing against ATF. You have certain political interests pushing up the ATF. Why haven't we had a director, a Senate-confirmed director, mm-hmm. in over 6-7 years?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you have a Senate-confirmed director, which, since we moved over to Justice, back in the day, the Secretary of the Treasury would just appoint a director.
Mm-hmm.
But now, under Justice, our director has to be a Senate confirmation. The hearings and come out of it. They just had one for that FOP guy, and he just...
Yeah, crash and burn. I think it's a political football, right? It's a political football. There's people who want to use the ATF to shut down gun folks like myself. You know, they want to dismantle or at least severely neuter the Second Amendment on one side. And then I think on the other side of that, there's people who try to act like they believe in the Constitution or try to make it look like they believe in the Second Amendment, but they really don't.
Which is 90% of ATF, I got to tell you. Mm-hmm. The problem is the bosses are all jockeying.
Mm-hmm.
And we haven't had a Senate-confirmed director since I retired. So they're acting directors, which means you have no clout, no juice. You can't come to a Senate or a congressional hearing and be shoulder to shoulder with the FBI director. Why? Because you're an acting director.
Mm-hmm.
So why hasn't there been an appointed director in the last 6-7 years?
That's a good question, man. And I think, well, how come, let's say, in Trump's tenure, and I don't know where you're at politically, it doesn't matter. If
well,
you know.
He forwarded a nomination. It was a really, really bad nomination.
Why?
Okay, I'm glad you said that.
But that's the point, though. Why did he put that guy up? How could that have been serious? I mean, Republicans killed that one.
Good point.
It's almost like a setup. It feels like I feel like ATF is a good scapegoat, and lots of people. So here's the thing I think about.
We are the government right now.
I think so.
We have an acting director,
yeah.
A deputy director who's a total tool.
Mm-hmm.
Total tool.
Yeah.
And just,
we still got Obama appointees in there. How? So the crazy thing to me is we're like, you know, we're here at this point, right, the end of 2020, and we've had Obama appointees in there for the last 4 years. How can even on the Republican side, how even on Trump's side, can these guys be serious about something? You know, they haven't really made any serious attempt. And then now we're looking at, like, possibly Biden coming in there. I think, you know, a jacked-up election. But Biden's coming in and already making plans to use the ATF to go after things. It's just this weird football where on the left or the right, it seems like they don't believe in the Constitution or specifically the Second Amendment, and they want to use the ATF as the scapegoat to do things they don't want to do.
The upper echelon of ATF might be hyper political, mm-hmm. because they want to keep their positions and want to keep things going. So if Biden or whoever mm-hmm. says do A, B, or C, they may do it. But they only have that much authority. Mm-hmm. Understand, our agency was enacted by an act of Congress. Mm-hmm. We have specific jurisdictions And Joe Biden or Donald Trump or Bill Clinton or whoever can say, oh, you will do this. No, you won't do this unless the Congress modifies the law. So it's not as dire as people would think, but it's scary because you have a acting director who will go where the political winds blow to keep her acting director position and maybe be nominated for a director's position in the Senate.
Yeah, yeah. Make sure to check out HankStrange.com. You can sign up for our email list and find ways to follow and support our efforts.